Hey guys, Mike here, one good short play. I feel I was probably a little bit too harsh on Back to the Future 3 in my last video, but I have always hated it. So no, I'm going to stand by that. I do apologise if you loved it, and I've got a feeling there are people who did. I've also got a feeling that that Mega Drive version, I might be totally wrong here, but I know with Shadow of the Beast it was certainly the case, that Mega Drive version might have been faster than the Amiga version, because the NTSC thing, was that an issue? Was that a thing with Shadow of the Beast? It was something like that anyway. It ran faster on the Mega Drive than on the Amiga, and it kind of slightly killed the game, but I think Gods had the same problem. But I really enjoyed Gods on the Mega Drive, because it was fast, it was good, something worked there. But I think Back to the Future 3 might have been the same in hindsight. Anyway, enough about that. This is Bad Omen for the Sega Mega Drive. If I remember right, this is a pinball game, isn't it? So let's have a blast at it. Never been that good at pinball games. Never been that into pinball computer games. Yeah, that looks like a pinball game. The way that demon was drawn. Yeah, never been that into pinball as a computer game. But remember, this one, I think, has... Oh, it's not a pinball. It's like a Pong. Or more of an Arkanoid. For my generation. Oh, can I? Yeah, I can. Oh, yeah, this was... I sort of recall this. I think I actually had a cart of this quite recently. But I exchanged it for something else. I have to be very, very, very selective about what Mega Drive games I have. Oh no! Because, can I? Oh yeah, I made it progress there. Because space is an issue with anyone who collects retro games. I'm sure anyone who collects retro games will agree. Oh yeah, progress. Whoa, what's that, dude? Scary. Space is the main issue. Alright, there's the cost. And that's another reason to be selective. But I think I was given this with my Mega Drive recently. Basically, I hadn't been collecting retro games for years, and I'd actually swapped about 6 or 7 years ago. More than that now, what, 10 years ago? 9, to be exact. 2006. Swapped me old Mega Drive from when I was a teenager, and all the games were talking 20 odd games. For Xbox 360 in 2006, which isn't as crazy as it actually sounds, because in 2006, of course, the Xbox 360 was worth something, and the Sega Mega Drive wasn't. Or maybe it was, but it wasn't to me, because I'd had it since I was like 16, played the games to death, and swapped it quite happily, quite willingly. I remember when I took it to Game Station, was it Game or Game Station? It was one of those two. They were very happy with the exchange, I remember that. And they gave me a used 360 with, I think it was the first Call of Duty game. Might be the Medal of Honor game, in fact. Demon! And yeah, I remember thinking, have I just been a bit ripped off here? But I went home and I really enjoyed the 360, which I still own to this day. I say still own because it was second hand. Oh, nasty. Because it was second hand. Oh, come on, continue. I'm enjoying that. I'm telling the story as well. Because it was second hand, I've had to replace it 4 times. For red rings, but I know now that there's ways to fix red rings, although I've never really done it. But they luckily, more and more begrudgingly as I went along, eventually did replace it. And I wasn't in the middle of telling you about this, I'll have another go. And in fact, that was pretty much it. Yeah, so about 20 odd really good games, and the kid was really, really, really excited. Let's do a time trial. So, yeah, and it wasn't until much later that. We're talking like a couple of years ago that I met up with my friend Graham from university, and he was always into retro games. Even when we were between the two of us into making films, that was kind of what we did at university all the time. You know, loads of little sort of sci-fi movies and stuff. And then I think he's a tech in a school now, and I went into games. But we met up in Bradford where we went to uni, and we went to like a Cash Converters in Bradford, and I was like, wow, look at all the retro games, they've totally forgotten about this. And he was buying some, and I just got, you know, you get like the bug, you get like an urge. I thought, no, I'll leave that alone. And anyway, I went and stayed at his, he lives just outside Bradford. Went and stayed at his that night, went and saw a band, and had a few bevvies. And when I left the next morning, well, we played on the SNES, that's right. Axel League. I've never played Axel League before, so he introduced me to that. Amongst loads of other SNES games, aren't there? And, but Axel League got really into it, just for the evening. And then the next day, he gave me a Mega Drive. He said, I said, let me show you. He said, no, I've got like five of these lying about. This one just about works. Take it home, clean it up. There's some games. And he gave me this for it as well. I think it was this. I'm pretty sure it was. There's also Dragon's Fury, which was quite similar, why I thought this was pinball. But I've since swapped this and Dragon's Fury, mainly because I've got enough space for 50 Mega Drive games, I think is my limit. Oh, look at that. Oh, 50 Mega Drive games is my limit. And I've probably got space for less now, actually, because I've got other consoles on the go. And it's just kind of built up from there. So I do want to come get in the head. Clearly you've got to get his, oh, his head, he's well out. Just getting in there. It's that bit, isn't it? His entrails, oh, he's blocking. Come on, yes. Oh no, no. Come on, I've got to be close to the game over is the problem. I want to just beat this baddie. Okay, yeah, so now as a result I have, oh, he's laughing at me, that's game over. Now as a result I have, let's have a look behind me. Some of it's not quite set up yet. I've got like two big shelves, and on it I've got, I think it's my brother's old Master System, Master System 2, the Mega Drive, a Dreamcast, which I'm currently lent to the school I work at. We've got like a retro arcade there, and they need to buy a new one so I can bring mine home. What else have we got? An empty space for an NES, because I really want one of those. I've got a SNES, a GameCube, a PS1, a PS2, although arguably everything you can play on a PS1 you can play on a PS2. The problem is the PS1's got kind of value in that it's my partner Jo's and she loved it and I kind of love it too, so you know, it's got a place on the shelf. And then an original Xbox, and weirdly enough, Xbox 360, and weirdly enough an Ouya, which was, I bought relating to my indie game development stuff. I wanted to get an Ouya. And I do love it, but again, for retro gaming, that's really all I ever use it for, retro gaming. So there you go, any random story that goes nowhere. Yeah, as a result of this one-off meeting with Graham, my mate from uni, I don't know if I told you his name before, but I just have now. That's why I'm... establishing that as my mate from uni, but as a result of that, yeah, it was. He's kindled a flame, and my retro gaming thing has really kicked off. But I've got to reel it in a little bit now, partly because of the cost, and I've got a little one, and partly because of the space. I want to. Part of the challenge is cutting down, you know, the space for all the games. I suppose one day I might do a video of it. I know all I've done so far is videos of games, but maybe it would be nice to start doing some videos kind of to camera. I know a lot of retro gamers do that. I wouldn't presume that anyone would want to watch that, but I might do it at some point. Just finding subjects to do it on, really. Anyway, I'm rambling, and we're just sitting here looking at the high score. Oh, no, the stage, select, screen. Let us depart. Oh, wow, you can choose different levels, that's cool. Let us depart, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching. That was, what was that? What was that called? Bad Omen, wasn't it? Although, apparently it was also known as Devilish. But I don't know if that's true or right. Anyway, save your Mega Drive. Thanks very much for watching.